we realized kind of intellectually that to a certain degree, the way we think about this planet, whether that's water on the planet, life on the planet, resources on the planet, we tend to think about it from the very much from the context of the surface, of a two-dimensional pale blue dot. And we realized that if we could transform our way of thinking about the planet to really encompass the challenges of three-dimensional science, of thinking about what the subsurface means in terms of exploration for life, understanding subsurface life, understanding water resources, understanding the distribution of other fluids and gases in the crust, that this could potentially transform how we think about the Earth, but most importantly as well, shed light then on how we might think about exploring other worlds.
One thing that stood out is that the surface of Mars is a hostile place. It is dry, cold, and it's bad radiation. So where would you want to be if you were a microbe or any form of life? You'd want to be underground is the philosophy. So that's what led me to this partnership with Barb over the last couple of years, because here's where the expertise lies to really understand what a planet like Mars should potentially behave like. And so we're transforming the knowledge that we're learning from the Earth and trying to fit that into the what we understand about Mars.
There are not a lot of mechanisms to really allow that much free thinking and interdisciplinarity. And I think it is that CIFAR is going to be particularly catalytic for us, to be able to bring together people from extremely different perspectives and then give them that intellectual freedom to challenge each other, challenge themselves to change the thinking.
Having life in this deep, long-term groundwater on Earth is just opening up an entire field of science that we did not know to exist 10 years ago. And so what does it mean? I think we're still trying to map that out. But in terms of a whole aspect of biology that was unknown and how it affects the surface, how it affects the interior, how biology actually works within these tight limits is really the importance of what's going on with the life underground.